Fine work with Hillock. Where'd you learn to fight like that? Oh, forget I asked. We Exiles have no history. Dominus took it from us when he had his blackguards dump us in the water out there. Here, got something for you. Should help you kill a few more of those undead bastards. Don't bother thanking me. The way I figure it, the longer we fighters live, the longer everyone lives. Got a job for you, if you're willing. There's a pool near the mudflats needs investigating. You'll smell it before you see it. Stinks like a carcass in high summer. But that's not the worst of it. Dead birds walking. Animals don't rise up again the same as people do here. So if they aren't raising themselves, what's doing it for them? The answer's in that fetid pool. Clear the place out and kill whatever's raising those rowers. We've got enough living dead to contend with already. Founded by Marseus Lioneye as a supply station for his campaigns against the Karui. In its day, Lioneye's watch could be defended by just a small garrison of well-armed legionnaires. What have I got? Handful of starving criminals with driftwood clubs and rusted hatchets. The Eternal Empire has some right nasty leftovers. Whether it's something in the air or in the water, no one stays dead in Rayclast. Not the first time. It can take a little while, but sooner or later corpses wake up and go looking for breakfast. Though they might look like you or I, behind those eyes there's nothing but darkness and hunger. Whatever's got inside those folks is not even close to being human. That hat Bestel wears? Saw him pluck it from the real captain's head right before the cannibals barbecued the poor bastard. Waste not, want not, I suppose. Yes, Bestel's got a gift for telling tales, but I'd never call him a liar. The truth's always in there. You just have to listen for it. Nessa's the one keeps the rest of us from losing our minds. To be honest, when she first arrived, I didn't think she'd survive more than a day, two at most. She's been proving me wrong every dawn since. Heard a bard once sing that the fairest flowers bloom in the foulest places. He's bloody well right. I've seen many an exile pass through Lioneye's watch, and many more that simply pass on. Those letters are my way of keeping track, of remembering. Aureath might want to forget us all, but I'll be damned if I will. That medicine chest you found, it'll do more than you might think. The medicine will run out, it always does, but Nessa won't. Give that girl a sliver of hope and she'll carry it to the end of the world. Farewell.
Black storms descend on us from the north. Unnatural tempests of rage and hatred, lashing our backs, tearing at our houses. The rain is shot with shadow. It withers our crops, sickens our livestock. And the wind carries with it a restless spirit that breeds melancholy and madness. A spirit that creeps through our dreams, weaves tales of misdeed around our resting minds. We try not to listen. We try to remember ourselves. Some of us forget. Brothers fight. Brothers die. Calm punishes those that quarrel, that steal, that murder. Yet still the nightmares goad us into malefaction. We Kardui are banished from sleep.
This is not what the elders told us. To kill is to live in Rayclast.
Thank you. Thank you. Tala Moana, warrior.
Black storms descend on us from the north, unnatural tempests of rage and hatred, lashing our backs, tearing at our houses. The rain is shot with shadow. It withers our crops, sickens our livestock. And the wind carries with it a restless spirit that breeds melancholy and madness, a spirit that creeps through our dreams, weaves tales of misdeed around our resting minds. We try not to listen. We try to remember ourselves. Some of us forget. Brothers fight. Brothers die. Calm punishes those that quarrel, that steal, that murder. Yet still the nightmares goad us into malefaction. We Kārui are banished from sleep.
Go to Hidekona.
Now that you've drained that passage, best I warn you about something. I was running down a wounded Roa one night's eve when I glimpsed something in that waterlogged cavern. Looked a bit like a sand spitter, only the size of a bloody ox. I reckon it's nesting down in those flooded depths somewhere. If you're going that way, then do us a favor. Spill the old shield crab's guts before it gets hungry and comes looking for us. Necromancer. Just the one, was it? Guess the bastard got a bit lonely, decided to make himself some pets. Well, good to see you don't mind getting your hands good and filthy. Here, to mark a dirty job well done. I've travelled inland on the Emperor's Road, via Prisoner's Gate. Had to skirt around Axiom Prison. That's the holdfast of Brutus the Warden. Bloody treacherous trip it was. Worth it? There's forest inland. Game, berries, fruit. More food than we can scrounge here. Most here wouldn't survive the journey. We'd be a damn sight easier if we could pass through the prison. Hey, past or through Brutus. You'll have more than a few lives owing to you. Rowers? Overgrown chickens with a murderous streak. If you're not careful, they'll talon your guts out and snap them up like big fat worms. That said, be sure to rifle through their nests if you get the chance. Rowers are like magpies, attracted to what shines. There's many a way to die in Rayclast. Most of them are mercifully quick. But you get caught alive by the Goatmen, you'll wish by any god you believe in that you hadn't. I've heard some of the more superstitious exiles say there's a deity these Goatmen worship. Abarath, Eater of Agony. Sounds like a right bastard if you ask me. So if the Goatmen hand you an invitation to go have dinner with the Cloven God, tell them where to stick it. Farewell.